Hey. We're live, by the way, now.
Hey.
Hey, everybody. This week on Ladies of Fandom, I've got Jessica Calvello appearing. Also with me, of course, are the lovely Tess, Alice, Alyssa, and you know myself. Anyway. Oh, and we've got a special guest, Minchie, who's kind of hidden behind the fan.
He's asleep. I didn't drug him. I don't know why he's so docile. He's normally crazy, but he's taking a nap.
I think he just loves everybody else.
There's a dog.
I think
there.
The energy from
There's
the room.
There's a dog there.
All right. Anyway, on to the credits, and we'll be back with the show in just a few seconds. As long as
your wind gets me.
It does.
We had Jessica Calvello. She's done a couple of fun voices, but I'm going to go ahead and let her introduce herself because she's amazing.
Oh, thank you. Hi, I'm Jessica Calvello. I am a voice actress. Do you want to say anything else?
No, it's your introduction.
Oh, so I've done a lot of voices for a lot of different anime roles for a lot of different anime companies, and I'm very happy to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you on.
A pleasure.
You were one of our first guests in mind when we started actually setting up the show schedule, so the fact that you're here with us today is, I'm excited.
Yay, we
got the confirmation email, and I'm dancing in my chair, so let's go ahead and move on to the interview. I'm going to go ahead and pick up my little stack of questions here that are hopefully halfway organized. About the introduction, how did you get started with voice acting?
Okay, so back in 1995, I was going to a commercial print modeling school. Those exist. So those are the schools that you go to, and they teach you how to smile, I've got a really great chihuahua. And then you're smiling with the chihuahua, and then your face is like on billboards and whatnot. So I'm sorry, Minchie, I totally disrupted you, and that was probably a bad idea. Good boy. Good boy.
He really is Minchie.
Never this calm. I did not drug my dog, I swear. He's okay.
Oh, yes, you can come over to me. Oh, my God.
Oh, I offended my dog. That's all right. Anyway,
so. He's a drug user.
He's like, you drug me. I don't want to sit with you anymore. Whatever, more for me. So anyway, so I was at this commercial print modeling school. I really was. And one of the teachers there, she said, Jessica, I work for this company called ADV Films, and they dub anime, and I think that you'd be really good, and so I'm going to give your name to Matt Greenfield, which was one of the directors there at the time, and they called me. I went in, and I did three lines for a show that no one has ever heard of called Evangelion.
I don't know that. We all know.
I'm being facetious. Facetious. Yes. That was my first gig with them, and then I just kept going, and then after a few years, I moved to New York, and then I worked for Central Park Media and Media Blasters and Taj Productions and 4Kids, and I did a lot of work there, and then I came back to Texas, and now I'm with Funimation, and Sentai Filmworks, Seraphim Digital, which was previously ADV Films, and mm-hmm. then I also, on occasion, work for Side 9 Happiness and Team 4-Star when mm-hmm. they'll have me, so yeah.
Yeah, the Team 4-Star mm-hmm. one, I know you've done Riff and Mikkel. Have you ever... What else have you done for Team 4-Star?
I'm in Final Fantasy 4-5. I play the mom. Ooh, I can't remember.
Uh-oh.
It's on my wiki. I should probably pull that up and look. I can't. It's yeah. one of them.
It's one of them. One of the we'll link it after the show in the show notes.
Link myself. Thanks.
And Team 4-Star, for those of you who don't know, if you don't know them, look them up. They did Helsing Abridged, Not Safe for Work, Dragon Ball Z Abridged, which is probably not also safe for work. I don't think Team 4-Star is safe for work.
They're awesome.
They're amazing guys. Yeah. They're also on the internet. Speaking of the internet, how has that changed the voice acting industry so far?
Oh, my God. So, again, back in the day, in 19... I'm going to beat you all with my cane. So, the internet had not been around too long, right? So, in 95, I mean, it had been, but AOL.com had just been born, I think. Mm-hmm. And so when you worked in the industry as a voice talent, you went into the studio for everything. There was no recording from home. Email couldn't handle files that large. You know, you were always in the studio working. And now, you know, I have recorded a number of things out of my own booth at home. So that has really changed it. I mean, you know, there was no Twitter, there was no Facebook, and so there's just a lot more exposure now. The convention, that whole culture has changed. Back in the day, I keep saying that, but it was a long time ago. But like my first convention was in 99, I think it was ACON, and that was one of my first conventions. And like, not only did they not really know who the English VAs were, but they also hated us if they knew.
Yeah.
I mean,
the,
you know, it was
subs versus dubs war.
Right.
Which was an actual war, strangely enough.
Yeah.
That war's still going on.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
it
but
it's still very much going on.
It is. But I mean, it was the conventions back then were all about the Japanese guests, which is great. I mean, but now they've kind of like switched a bit to where now they really focus on the American guests. I wish there's a little bit more of a balance there, but that's changed. I mean, everything has changed, and so in some ways it's really great, but I do miss some of the old school things about when I first started working, like paper. Because you'd go into the studio and you'd have this just one screen where the animation was, and then you had a music stand with your script on it.
Yeah.
And sometimes I'd like highlight my lines, and or I'd write notes, like if I, you know, had to do another take and the director said I need that faster, I'd write faster real quick so then I could remember that, as because I really would forget actually like what I was supposed to be doing. And then sometimes like you could leave little notes on scripts for the VA that was gonna be in there after you, like Lisa Ortiz and I would leave little notes on the screen. You know? Like, so like that stuff's gone, you know, because now you go in and there's two, I'm talking a lot.
So you guys would cross paths. You know,
we cross paths.
Ships in the night.
But I mean, and we still see each other in that way, like crossing. But there was just, it was just a little bit different back then. Now when you go in, you really just go into the booth and you stand there and you voice act, and you've got two large screens. One's got the anime on one, and then the other one has a script, and the script scrolls, and you just, your eyes just go back and forth, and you try to hit the sync as best as you can. And It's easier in some ways, because I ruined a lot of my own takes from holding the scripts too close to the mic, like especially with Excel Saga. I was always like, and like, I can't tell you how many times I like knocked the microphone with my energy.
Is fluttering paper.
Exactly. And they're like, Jessica, put the script down. I'm like, damn it. So, you know, there's that.
That must have been.
I would have loved to see the outtakes of that.
Oh, I hurt myself in many ways. I would like, I'd have like little nail, like from clenching my fists with anger and love.
Yeah,
so it was.
I've seen the behind the scenes of the Team Four Star voice actors who play Saris. I cannot remember her name, but I am bad with names, as we saw earlier today.
But I don't understand. He is never this guy. I did not drug my dog.
I feel like a Bond villain, though.
A Bond.
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.
That looks like it gets intense. Like, how do you keep your voice during some of those scenes? Because she is screaming at the top of her lungs.
Yeah.
For the episode.
Yeah, for, you mean for Excel Saga, right?
Yeah,
so,
for any of it.
For any of it. And Hanji, too. Hanji screams a lot. Mink from Dragon Half Woo! Screamed a lot. Mink fans. So basically, honestly, the best way that I know is if I've got a tough session coming up, I don't talk. I know that sounds really, I don't talk, and then I'll do tons of this stuff. It's so nasty. It's called throat coat. It is because like the main ingredient is like licorice, whatever that plant is. Yes.
Ugh.
It's, and I hate licorice, and it's like molten, vomity stuff.
It's gross.
It's so nasty. And then there's a Chinese cough syrup that a lot of us use called like loquat pong, I don't know. And it's black sludge. And so with all of that and just keeping myself like not talking a lot, I can usually, you know, persevere and get through a tough session.
Just have a day when you walk around with a whiteboard around your neck and like, we're not talking.
I did do that during Excel Saga. I didn't speak at all.
Goodness.
Yeah. I'd go to order coffee and I'd be like, and they'd be like, who's this crazy girl? And I'm like, you know, coffee, please. And they'd be like, and everybody would do this. They'd go, can you not talk? And I'd be like, obviously I'm not going to talk and tell you I can't talk.
So, speaking of Excel, who was the most difficult to get into character for? Because I know Excel, Mink, those were all some pretty crazy fun characters.
I don't think I've had trouble getting into character for any of them. I think that I think for me, I look at what the energy levels are, and then from there we pick the personality, and then I think the voice just comes out. And so I think that I don't have trouble doing that, you little napper, you. Oh, he's just, okay.
Comfy. Okay.
He's making a liar out of me. He is asleep. Okay.
You're just like, he's the worst. He's going to be just such a diva.
I just knew. I was like, it's like, a mistake to bring him. And he's like, no, I'm chill.
Totally chill. That is amazing. Hey, by the way, the dog's name, Minchie, is named after the dog in Excel Saga.
Yes. Aww. He is my emergency food rations.
But apparently he's giving himself to me.
Apparently he wants you to eat him, so that's fine. I'm not jealous.
Totally.
It's fine, Minchie.
Okay. So, related Loyalty. Question. Who was the weirdest, just technically, to voice? I know Excel is
Excel
hard.
Excel Saga. No, but go ahead. What?
Because I know that there are a lot of extremes between the voices. Like, there are some that are just your normal everyday voice. You don't get much excitement. But then Excel, she was screaming like 5 minutes.
The whole time.
The whole time.
Yeah.
So technically speaking, who was the most difficult to voice and record for?
You know, so Excel Saga. But, you know, another one that was really, really challenging was Kaneko from Maria Hollick. I don't know if you guys have seen Maria Hollick. Well,
I have,
she's... Have you?
Kind of. I think I've seen a couple of the episodes so far.
She's, she is a very excited, she's sort of like Excel's cousin, 7 times removed. Oh, she's hyper, she's a raging lesbian, which is great, and she loves the ladies a lot, and she's really crazy. It's typecast. take that as you will. But anyway, but that was tough. Like, she was just, she spoke so fast. So a lot of the characters, you know, like her and Excel Saga and Mink too. And then there's another character, no one has ever seen this show. It's called Princess Minerva. It's this little 28 minute, you're smiling. Have you heard of it?
Yes.
Have you seen it?
I think it's been a very long time.
Oh my God, that was like one of my first leads. And that was so fun. And again, it's the show made no sense at all. And it was just this really bizarre, crazy chick. And, so, I mean, it is tough to keep that energy up, but, you know, once I'm there and you just start going, it's pretty easy to maintain.
That's good.
Yeah.
There is a related question. I don't remember what the question was. There was a related question. I'll probably find it halfway through the stack here in a minute, so I'm going to move on to, this is a little bit more serious. We did talk about this a little bit earlier. You play a lot of pretty powerful women. How has anime empowered women and girls, and how has that changed over the years? Because I remember anime from the 80s being far superior to the TV shows out of the 80s just because the girls were so awesome. But then again, there were also a lot of anime that wasn't so kosher for women empowerment.
Mm-hmm.
Have you noticed it changing, or?
I'm going to answer that with a question. Do you find anime empowering to women? And if so, because I have
that
a struggle
really
with that
depends
question.
Depends where you look.
Well, is this that? Like, okay, so Attack on Titan. I find Hanji to be a wonderfully empowering woman. She's strong and smart, and she's sexy in her own way, and she's interesting, and I find that very empowering. But I don't necessarily find another character who doesn't look like Hanji and act like Hanji to not be empowering. But specifically, I don't know that as a whole is anime empowering to women. I think I can pull out certain characters that I think that are. But, I mean, what do you guys think?
I think it depends on where you look. Especially the shoujo.
Yeah.
The shoujo-specific anime, especially a lot of the recent ones, I think.
So give me some titles.
Is.
I haven't...
Garden of Words, Your Name, which apparently has won a ton of awards, and I need to see it. Even something like Naruto recently.
Okay.
Sailor Moon, of course.
Oh, yes.
That one, you can't ignore Sailor Moon. That's like the biggest shoujo title in
There's
America.
There's also Utena. Utena is really empowering.
Utena, yeah.
I saw the movie with the car.
Yes.
Where she turns into a car. Oh, yeah. And I met the creator. I met the creator of that whole thing. Oh, and we asked him at the
car.
We did. No, it was the most frustrating. I'm totally derailing, but I got
it's fine.
It was so frustrating. We wanted to know, like, explain yourself, like all these things that, because we the convention was Big Apple Anime Fest 1,000 years ago, and he was one of the main guests. And so we showed the movie, and then we had a Q&A after. And so we were like, "What happened?" And every single time he'd go, "It's a secret." Like, that's what he said every time. And so finally was like, "Please tell me, why did she turn into a car?" And it's like quiet. And we really think that, because this is the end of the panel, and he's just been saying it's a secret the whole time. And we're thinking, okay, he's going to give us something. And sure enough, he's like, "It's a secret."
Oh my God.
So, anyway, I don't know why I told you that story.
It's a pretty
room. You will tell me your secrets.
It's actually pretty fun to segue.
It's a secret.
Strawberry shortcake. I'm a huge strawberry shortcake.
Bring this woman strawberry shortcake.
It's my jam. Get it? Strawberry shortcake is my jam. Oh, God. Okay, my dog hates me. Come on, you guys. Don't leave me. Don't let me stay. I have just lost all of your subscribers. Please come back. I'm sorry. I'll never pun again. But I love strawberry shortcake. And as a little girl when I was growing up, I really looked up to her, and I just thought that she was amazing, and I love the whole, and now here's maybe slightly related, the Strawberry Shortcake franchise now is, they're a little bit, flatted up a little bit.
What?
Like, have you seen the newer, yeah, no. Isn't that crazy? Like, they got, like, the knee-high things going on, and, like, the short skirts, and I was like, that's not the Strawberry Shortcake guy. Let a little girl be a little girl as long as possible, because eventually we're going to be this, right? Which is fine.
Confession time, I still dress like a princess every now and then. There's
your
a gold
dress is one now.
You are a princess. Yes. You're dressed as one. You are one. But you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, oh, what?
Why does everything have to get the brats, like, glazed? Like, they did with my Little's Pet Shop. It drives me nuts. Like, Little's Pet Shop.
That's how they ruined Powerpuff Girls.
I haven't seen any of the new one. I love the original.
They
fired
half the cast.
Oh, well, I don't know anything about that girl. I don't know anything about it.
You don't get the dirt?
I do not keep up with that. But I love the Powerpuff Girls. I'm sorry, would you like to give questions? So anyway, yesterday I was walking down the street, and oh my God, I was naked. Okay, the end.
And then I brushed my teeth, I made some toast.
I had a muffin, it was gluten-free.
So obviously, Strawberry Shortcake's on the list, but what or who do you fangirl hardest over?
Oh, I'm a huge Buffy the Vampire Slayer fan.
Oh, you baby boy.
Yes,
I don't wear the cheese. The cheese wears me.
Talk about a strong woman. Oh my God. Yes. I looked up to her. I still do. Fangirl hardcore over that show. Love
nice.
It.
Any others or just Buffy?
Willow from that show.
Willow's amazing. What else? This is not anime, but I'm a hardcore music fan. I can't get enough music. I'm always at live music shows. I love live music. I love all kinds of music. Name it. I love it. And I love film and I love art. I fangirl over lots of that artsy stuff.
Nothing wrong with that. You should see my Spotify playlist.
Can you share it with me?
Yeah. I can. Keep in mind there are some pretty strange things on there, but hey.
Hello. If you saw what's on my Nano, you'd be like, oh, skinny puppy to Grieg. Hey, I'm versatile.
I've got several things like that.
Yeah.
Have you met any of your Japanese counters or any interactions?
Doppelganger.
I want to meet Kotona Mitsui. She's so bad. So she's Celsia in Those Who Hunt Elves, who I'm Celsia. I think she's Mink and Dragon Half. Oh my gosh, I need to fact check that, but I think she's Mink and Dragon Half. And she's Excel. So I feel like I need to meet her at some point.
Oh my goodness, that's your Japanese doppelganger.
I know.
You haven't met her because you're her when
you
fall
are
asleep.
Her.
No, but here's something. Oh my God, this is like so an crazy thing, amazing thing. I'll never forget it. When I was recording for Excel Saga, I had become friends with the seiyuu who voices Naga and Slayers. Did I say all that
yes,
right?
Yes, okay. So like, absolutely. Ooh, ooh, ooh,
ooh. Yep, that one, right?
Naga
okay,
left.
Naga, right. yes.
Is that where the stereotype started?
Yes.
Man.
We're nice. One of them. I don't know. But Maria, I think it's Kawamura. I think that's her name. Maria Kawamura.
Fact. It will be in the
Google.
Notes.
Yeah. Sorry, I should be before I speak.
There's like a Dragon Half reference in Slayers in one of the movies, I think, where she's chilling and there's like the slime half like bops along and plays with her boob. And she's like, stupid slime half, get out of here. Why don't you go play with the Dragon Half?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
Makes it.
Her and I had become friends. We were pen pals for a while. I met her at a convention, and she was the big guest, and she's lovely. And she was friends with Katona Mitsuishi, and so I wrote her a letter, and I said, could you just tell Miss Mitsuishi that I'm a huge fan, and I admire her, and I'm having, you know, trouble, and I'm, you know, her Excel is just, you know, the best thing ever, and I could never come close, and blah, blah, blah. And so she responded. She said, I gave her your message, and she said to tell you hello, and she wishes you the best of luck, and I died. I died. I still have that letter that she wrote to me telling me that, and I'll cherish it forever. It's just, nice. It was amazing.
Okay, so one of those follow-up questions that I warned you about, what are some of your favorite fan interactions or interactions with other people in general? Like, what's the most inspiring or what are the most funny ones? Any convention stories that are safe for... PG-13.
Oh, and now that you've said that, I got nothing to say. No. well, I tell you, my favorite thing about going to the conventions are the fans. I love interacting. I love hearing why they like something, especially if a character that I have voiced, they feel particularly strong about for maybe something that they're going through. There's been a lot of people that have come up to me and said, you know, Hanji's helped them through certain situations in their lives that they were struggling with. That makes me feel really, really good. I was one of the conventions I went to. This guy really wanted to talk to me. We sort of went off into a corner, and he made me cry. You know, just some of the struggles that he's going through, and how he feels inspired by Hanji. And so those are my favorite interactions. Those are my favorite things to do at the convention, is really talk to the fans. Specific interaction, I can't think of one. I'm sure there is one, and I know there are some that are inappropriate right now. But, yeah.
After show. That's fun.
This is why we have fans, Ladies of Fandom, After Dark.
Yes.
We do? Wait, what?
When? Is there a poll involved?
Oh, there can be.
Courtney wanted me to ask you.
Jeffrey, we need you.
Jeffrey. Where's Jeffrey when we need him? Okay, total
Jeffrey. Oh, that was pre-show. Wah, wah.
Total non-sequitur. Do you play any video games?
Okay, I'm going to tell you guys something, and you're not going to want to be my friend.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
I have been playing American McGee's Alice since...
Actually, that just makes me want to be your friend even more.
No, wait, but I'm not done, because you're going to, like... If you had any respect for me, you shouldn't have, and you're really not going to now. This is, like, so sad. I have been playing that game since it came out in 2001, and it scares me so badly that every time I go to play, I get scared, and I'm still on... I just made it to, like, level 12. Y'all, I'm sorry.
Now, to be fair, I have to say this. You're a braver woman than I am.
I'm so scared. And the soundtrack is so scary.
Because I love American Music Alice. It's a great game.
It's so good.
And I refuse to touch it because they had to tie me to a chair to watch Alien.
No, we didn't have to
tie me. So you get scared of stuff, too.
Yes,
I get terrified.
You know.
Right, now we need to do a ladies and Jessica watch.
we totally should.
I know.
We totally should. I can't handle any of that stuff. And so, and then if Minchie, like, jumps and... My dog is dead. My dog has died. I don't know what has happened to you.
He looks pretty doped out right now.
Really, I did not give him Benadryl. I love you more than the sun, and I don't know what's happened, but you, okay.
It's Alice's siren song.
Meeting everybody. Put him to sleep.
Oh, what is your devil magic you've done to my dog? Anyway, I don't know what the question was.
Video games.
I love SSX Tricky. I still play that.
You might have to remember, is it?
Snowboarding.
Sports. Okay, yeah.
That is the snowboarding game. I haven't played that in forever.
Somebody needs a shove. I love that.
Those are always fun. Related question that I finally found. Do you have a preferred character type?
Like, for who I'm dating, or like...
to play as...
Wow, that got deep.
I didn't know what we were talking about. After Dark. My character. I like playing the comedic roles. Mm. That is my forte. I like the funny. I played Eclair in Fairy Tale the movie, which was a real, that was the most hilarious movie. No, oh my God, it was so sad. Why am I laughing? It was such a sad movie and a sad role. So, I love the laughing. And so I really gravitate toward those zany, crazy characters. And
I mean, if you're going to be playing a character, overplay a character and go for comedy.
And if anyone can overdo something, it's me.
Now, Alyssa, it's time for your question. I'll let you ask this one.
Okay. Imagine there is a Thunderdome-style battle royale.
Okay.
Which character do you think would end up on top and why? Who would win out of all the characters you voice?
Okay. This is a complicated answer, you guys. I can't just be like, oh, blah, 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 blah.
Explain it.
You have to do science.
That would be my obvious choice. Be like, Hanji, right? Because she has the brains. She can maneuver her gear, so she'd be able to kill anyone, right? Is that our warning?
That is our warning.
Okay. But if you were to actually put, like, all of my characters into one arena, I really think the person that would win would be Excel, because they'd be so scared of her. Like, she's just so psycho.
I mean, she's also unkillable.
She's unkillable. That's my other point, right? This great will of the macrocosm would come and revive her, and everyone would be like, WTF, and run. Like, I really think Excel would just... Do you have an opinion?
No. All right, wrapping up, do you have any announcements that you'd like to make?
I have some conventions coming up. I have HazardCon in Philly in the summer, and then I'm also going to convention, it's called CTX, nice. And that's a little bit later in the summer as well. That's in Austin.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah, yeah. And then I was, just before I went in, there's a convention in the UK that I think I'm going to, but I'm not quite formally announced yet. And then that's those announcements.
All right. So next week on Ladies of Fandom, thank you so much to Jessica Calvello. But we also have another guest next week. We have two of them, in fact. It's going to be Creepy Cosplay. You know one half of them as Harley on fan service. The other half of Creepy Cosplay will be on with us next week, as well as Harley. That's a wrap.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you for having me.
Also, don't forget to go to jessicacavello.com, and I'm done now. They cut me off.
Yay. Are you sure? You guys, I get so hyper and I can't stop talking.
Oh, it's fine. That's what we want. They were worried.
I want a picture of all of us.
I was like, yeah.
Can you take our picture?
Yes.
Thank you.
They're going to kick us out.
They're going to kick us out like now.
No, you're going to use a white chair. Never mind. That was perfect. That is like a camera ready dog.
Once again, we try to look on the bright side of life with Good For You.
This year, Archer will fully embrace the 1940s for their 8th season. Good for you.
Riverdale is premiering January 6th on the CW.
Yes! Yes!
If you can't tell, she is excited by this.
I want
she handles holding her emotions so well.
I do not care that it rates as nostalgia porn. It's Archie and company played up with Twin Peaks style. Plus, Machen and Mika's in it, and everyone knows that if you see promo stuff for a show that looks kind of creepy and campy, but you're not sure about liking it, and then Machen pops into frame, and you're like, I'm on board. Bring it.
Yes, and we all know that campy and creepy are two flavors that were always meant to be together.
Yes, they are.
The CW reboot of Charmed could be interesting, especially with the Jane the Virgin writers, but we need to wait and see how that develops. We've had many of an upset. Good team, good writers, looks like it's going to be good. And then, what is it? What are those parasites that come in?
Producers?
Yes, yes, those. Those come in and screw it all up.
Yes. You would think that I would also be pushing for another season of the Gilmore Girls revival, but no. No, thank you. Please. The later seasons of the original show made me upset, and parts of the revival made my brain actually try to leave my body.
And shoot itself.
It was not pleasant.
Yes. It wasn't.
The only cure for Gilmore, overdose, and our rage is to rewatch the first season and then walk away forever. It worked for me, and hopefully it will help cure others as well.
You should just watch the first season, delete it off your feed, and then walk away.
Just
fall
away.
Yes. And hopefully, on that upbeat note, you will help you find the positive in your life. From Good For You, good night.
To everyone, good for you.
Tonight, everyone.
We were surprised with a few minutes of extra time.
We're like, hey!
We're ready! Fortunately, we are ready.
So, just give us a little bit about ourselves, about what we do and everything else like that. It's basically, we take everyday household items, whether it be a golf tee, a belt.
And we make stuff. We make props.
All sorts of things.
Costuming props. Decorative props, something nice to put in the bathroom.
Maybe some traps.
Traps.
You know, traps.
Yeah.
We'll get to that later. That's probably going to be for our monsters.
And our theme
horror.
This month, just to keep everybody in the loop, is fantasy. And so we've gone kind of a dark route with that. So we have...
I have no idea how that happened,
We started with a little crown. Let's see if we can... I don't know where all these cameras look. We have this crown.
This crown right here. So we started with a dark fantasy crown.
And then we ended up last week with this whole scepter that kind of goes along with it. We've got some of the same tie-in features, some of the webbing, some of the deals here.
So what I really thought was kind of cool is that, you know, we got this little dark mistress, queen, king, or whatever going on. I'm like, you know what? This person needs to guard their wrist.
Yes!
I have no idea why.
They need decorative pieces, guard pieces. Here's what we need to do. Stop everything!
Stop everything! Oh, we gotta get back.
It's so much brighter back here.
It is really bright.
Let's be here where we can see things.
Alright.
So you get started.
Alright, I will.
Alright.
What's the clock? We got about
we've got a clock. Yeah, because we switch every 2 minutes for those who haven't been watching the show. For those who haven't been watching the show, hi, I'm Chris.
I'm Jeffrey.
This is Jeffrey. We
and
got
this
a show.
Is
we build things.
Combat.
Combat Creations. All right.
And
are you ready?
Yes.
Go!
Go! Alright, so we got the gauntlets right here. We're going to go ahead.
And so what we've done is, here, I'm going to take one of these while you start looking.
Alright.
We took just a piece of foam, really easy craft foam. You can find this all over the place as a base. And we cut, this is a gauntlet pattern. This is a trapezoid. Ooh, trapezoid. And it's about the right length to go over an arm. Now later, off camera, we'll finish it up.
Do we have cutters somewhere in our hardware?
Dude.
Oh.
Later.
There we go.
Between shows, we'll finish up some of the things that we can't do in the 20 minutes that we are on the show. In the case of these, that would be adding some straps of some sort, a little Velcro so it stays on your arm, probably a little paint. Because they said in the studio, if we paint in here and get high on the fumes again, they're not going to let us have more show time.
We don't talk about that episode.
We don't talk about that. All right, so basically, what we're doing here is as much as we can do in the time allotted. Which happens to be most of the construction in this case. We use some hot glue here because it's the easiest to deal with in the time allotted. If we need to go back and play with some epoxy later, we definitely can. So Jeff is starting with, that's a beautiful leather bits.
I just burned myself. And by the way, just so you guys know, it is not a show unless I burn myself.
That's right. We wait until Jeffrey burns himself. We're going to get him some...
Am I on time? I can't see the clock.
The clock? Oh, close enough. Switch!
Switch! Switch!
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I thought we started
and
it.
And go! All right, yeah,
okay.
Woo! All right. So, so I thought...
This is on backwards.
I know, but... Oh, are you actually going to do it that way? All right.
Well, the buckles are there.
So the nice thing that we have all these crates next to us, and basically what we do, we go through the crates. We actually... rarely even talk to each other over the weekend. We're like, do you want to take the piece and work on it? Do I want to take the piece? And we'll just go from there. You know, we get together, have lunch or whatever. But the nice thing is about, in our crates, we actually have random items. We have no idea what any items...
Ugh.
What the hell is this? We have no idea what any of the items that we have. The really nice thing is that we actually just recently got a really nice big giant crate of... donations from Lance Allen. We thank you very much for that. He was a Woo-hoo! Guest on our show, a fill-in, when Chris couldn't. So we have all sorts of items in our crates, and we have no idea what's inside. So we've been kind of going through some things and such like that. And I'm already having my eye on something that's in this box down here. Like, we have, like, probably 8 boxes around us. Last month we did post-apocalypse. This month we're doing fantasy. And then the month after, which is March, we are doing horror. And then we actually got, you know, we asked you as the viewers of Fandom, hey, what would you like us to do? And people said, oh, let's do horror. Oh, let's do superheroes and villains. Let's go ahead and do pirates. Rake,
I think of death and destruction.
Yeah, I mean, you know, oh, I'm not a virgin. I'm not going to die. Blah, 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 blah. You know, little things like that. It's like the classic horror movie, right?
What?
I don't know.
What planet are you on?
I'm still trying to decide. My mom hatched me. What can I say? No, really, she hatched me. I mean, you know, whatever. She's a dinosaur.
So
I love her. She's
what
not
I've
a dinosaur,
done is I've added
mom.
A couple of spiky bits because
Whoa!
We put those on the other pieces. I have no idea in the end if this is going to wear well or just get in everybody's way, but at least we're going to... Oh, switch!
Well, we'll definitely find out. Wow.
But at least it there's a tie-in of some sort, right? And I think
really
in the long
tie-in.
Run, when we get around to painting, the foam will probably end up black. But really, these other things that we're adding on, I kind of like the color there. So, feathers. Jeff, feathers, I tell you.
I love feathers.
Followers of the show may remember last week where we were talking about having extra people. But it was decided that, number one, my big old belly was going to turn and slap somebody off of the stage.
So we're still working out the mechanics for all that.
Yeah, still working out mechanics. But in reality, Kristen, who's... I gave her the wrong last name. It's Kristen Hammock. But Kristen, if you're at home getting better, she fell ill along with a pile of kids. She fell
ill
under a pile
never
of kids.
Great. Poor thing.
And so we wish her well, and she will get to us on the show, but that'll be a little later on.
In the
meantime, Jeff is adding some feathers. And still, he's got
Don't
some black feathers,
me.
He's got some white feathers. Since the theme that we have going in the other pieces is kind of a darker theme, the use of the black feathers really ties into the whole thing, which is part of really what you need to do And so as soon as I say that, he adds a white one. So it really, the key piece when you're doing props over several props and trying to make everything work together is to take a look at what little bits you can tie in across the pieces, whether it's a simple color, in this case, kind of darker colors, whether it's an actual piece, part of it, like the little spiky bits that we've got going on, whatever the case may be. Once you get some...
Ow! Sorry! That,
Switch!
Switch! Oh, that's gonna... I'm good! I'm great! Oh! So, really safety like first, this. Guys, but unfortunately, because we're moving so quickly and such like that, we unfortunately cannot, I can't put on gloves because they're just really big and chunky and they're a little hard. I mean, you know, we're professionals. We do this all the time, legitimately. So, yeah, take a look at that, guys. Look at these. Where they at? There we go. That's pretty neat.
All right.
So, let me get...
I almost don't want to... You know what? I know what I want to do.
What are you going to do? This is what I like we do. We just talk about, hey, what do you want to make? All right, we'll make little gauntlets, bracers. Let's do a shoulder piece. Okay, cool. And we don't even discuss how we're going to make it. Every 2 minutes, of course, you can see us that we're basically taking, oh, God, don't cut yourself. We're basically just switching off every 2 minutes and adding whatever it is. We have no idea. Hey, he might take a piece off and, like, right here, he took a piece off and flipped it and went that way.
I want to give it sort of a little fan. Now this, what I'm doing is I'm just adding a bit of foam to the back here, kind of give it kind of an arched effect. I'm using foam so that when I curve the whole piece, it will curve with it. And I'm leaving it the white foam is there so that when I paint it, it will also get black.
That's really smart. I definitely like that idea. And, you know, if they don't bend like we want them to, I'm sure we can figure out another way to use these because it's, you know, it's costume pieces that we make. You take everyday household items, rather it be a trophy.
Hold this up.
What?
No, not you. I talked to the skeleton's going to hold that up for me.
Oh, I was like, who are you talking to? We have a new assistant. His name is Skelebutt. Skelebutt. I'm going to talk to him. You're almost out of time.
I'm almost out of glue.
You're almost out of glue? That's not good. Where's the glue?
I got it. I glued it.
Ooh, I know what I'm going to do for this. I'm not going to show you. This is mine.
I burned myself.
Oh, did you? Oh, yeah, no. So that's the nice thing about hot glue. You burn yourself for a moment and it like cools off. Really, don't burn yourself, guys. It really hurts. It really hurts. Lance Allen, wherever you are, sir, you burned me good. I think. Or it was me who burned. I have to go back on the episode and check it out. So, guys, don't ever forget, we're always from After Ladies of Fandom, which are amazing. We're always from 9:30 to 10, and, you know, we got a little interlude in there.
Is it time?
Yeah. Oh, it's a switch! It's a switch!
I'm taking my helper with me.
I was just kind of, like, going off and such like that.
Be careful. I had it over while it was cool. Who cares? It's all good.
It's all good. Right. It's all good.
Oh, so that's kind of cool. So if we found a little packet there so you can keep your magic cell phone on your armor.
Magic cell phone.
You're gonna need a lot more glue than that.
You know what?
Like a whole stick of glue.
I'm going.
Isn't he going to need that, Buster Bones? Look.
You've lost it.
Look, we needed an extra person.
We
give Mr. Bones his own helmet.
Where is he?
Magic! See? He totally disappeared! I could do this all day. Hey, you're supposed to be crafting. Alright. While you do that, I'm gonna see what else is over here.
I really don't know what to say.
Oh, this is Iron Man.
No! Yes!
Oh, it's got sounds!
Someone help me, please. He's a child. There's a child! Someone claim your child!
Bow! Bow. Hey, that's kind of cool.
I have no idea how this is going to work. I don't want to
use that on a prop.
No, I want the other way. Oh, yeah. Okay. I don't understand you sometimes. Wait, that's the way I want it. That's the way I want it.
So here's a tip. When you're putting stuff together, you know, figure out what you want before you start just throwing glue all over the place.
Hey, I want it like this.
But if you have to throw glue all over the place, hot glue at least, you can peel back off and use it again. in another
and
direction.
Again, and again. Gloomy! Oh, I got a minute left. Gloomy! Come on! Get it! Get in there. Yeah. Glue
there you
it.
Go.
Glue it like a Polaroid picture or something like that.
What?
I don't know. Don't
see, in other places, when you're crafting on your own, you have to put your own hot glue in. That's crazy.
It is kind of crazy. I'm just saying.
All right, what you...
You said a lot of glue.
You spent the whole
2 minutes
sticks? Putting that one. Yeah, that's okay. That's all right.
I'm about to glue your head to your helmet.
All right. That way it's safe. All the time. Switch.
All right, there you go. That's my piece. But look at, check that out. Check how that Velcro is like that.
Oh, Velcro.
I love it.
That's actually kind of neat. See? All right. Here's what I'm going to do on this one.
What are you going
to
do?
So this is where we're GP. Now, we have the pair, which would be kind of neat to do kind of the same thing across to make a match.
Yeah.
But we only have one of these things.
Only one.
Now, on the crown, we've got the whole wire stuff going on and moss. Hey, look for some moss.
Moss?
Look, I've got some of the wire.
Going in for
and moss. And I've got a thing with nothing on it that needs some stuff. So we're going to cut some wire here.
Found the cheerleader.
Ooh, that just flies.
We can use
through.
The cheerleader again. Never mind.
We could. I mean, there are all kinds of ideas out there. Some are good, and some involve the cheerleader.
Ooh, that just felt so nice.
All right, so I've got a little bit of the... Oh, you know what? I'm going to bend this in so it's not as pointy.
I found some moss!
When you're working with wire like this, you just bend the end over. And it'll keep most of the points on the inside. And I'm going to glue that right down the middle here. And I'm not going to talk much while I'm focused on what I'm doing. Fortunately, Jeffrey's here to make some noise. Hey. What are you doing?
I don't know. I didn't do anything. What are you talking about? I'm just a head coming out of the side.
Hey, I'm running low on glue.
I can't find, I found some moss, okay? So, are you gluing glue? All right, gluing you. You are now glued. All right, so it's been a night for all of us, guys. So don't forget, always forget, you can, as we're live.
You know what I hear? Gavin, a fan service, I hear it's his birthday.
You did?
I heard that.
You, monkey, get him. Go get him. Go. We have a stage monkey. Don't worry about
it. He turned old.
Did he? Did he turn old?
He's...
How old did he turn?
Old enough to tell kids to get off his lawn.
I love it. So guys, don't forget, we're live streaming here through YouTube. So on the little chat window, you can go ahead and type the live thing. And we're about to have Gavin come on board. Gavin, come on up.
Oh my God, what the hell are you people doing?
Gavin!
Sir, come on up, sir. So we're going to take a small little break. And
whoa,
in the
safety,
middle.
Safety.
Wait, where's the other
you
one?
Messed
the
up my hair
it's out of the way. You damn straight.
All right, Gavin. So welcome to the show. Everyone, this is Gavin Stone.
Hey.
Producer, Fanboy TV. He is executive.
I'm way more than the
and, sir, so what we're doing, just to kind of show you what we've been doing is a high dark fantasy and such. So we made a crown. We made a weird-looking scepter.
I don't even know what that was last week.
That was, and now we're making little bracers.
Table centerpiece.
How neat is that?
When you're having,
but
the scepter works as a centerpiece when you're having
so
evil
everyone,
banners.
It is Gavin's, it was Gavin's birthday, and so everyone from Fanboy TV to you, sir.
That's all right, this is live TV.
We give you a happy birthday present, because we love you. We had everyone on the show,
all
the shows, go ahead and sign
full,
in, such
the
like
full
that.
Fan service block
what
party.
What is this from?
I don't know, Harley would know.
Oh,
Harley, if you're out
Paw
there.
Patrol. Bet you.
Paw Patrol.
Paw Patrol. I saw it and I was like, oh, that's cute. Why not? Let's get that.
Oh, that's
it just,
awesome.
It just screamed you. It screamed you.
And then, you know, we're doing the big party Saturday with all sorts of fun.
We are. We're doing a huge party here.
Lance wants a rematch of Aliens versus Predator, just so you know.
Oh, Lance is going down.
All right, so.
Well, Gavin, we definitely want to thank you for coming on our show. And, you know, we always got to make sure it's safety first. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Safe.
Oh,
do
right.
That.
And remember, we're combat creations. All right, sir, get on out of here. We thank you so much, Gavin, for being on our show.
So, and, finishing up this little thing.
Let's go ahead. I'll start out.
You got
just
a little bit of moss here?
I got a little bit of moss. We're going to go ahead and do that.
I was thinking that that'd be good because we've got some tied in with the wire on the wire one.
And go. All right, there we go.
Yeah,
so that was just a little musical intro type little thing.
Hey,
it wasn't really musical.
Go.
I don't know.
Tell you to do it. So basically, the moss here, what I was telling you, we've used that in the other two props. So using it in this one as well kind of ties them all in again. Another piece to tie it all in and make it a cohesive. We need to get you like little finger condoms. For protecting your fingers.
I don't think having latex on my fingers and hot glue is going to help.
I think we should try it and find out what happens.
If you dare me to go ahead and try this and see what happens, message us at fanboytv.com or just comment on the side here and ask, and I'll do it.
Yeah, so as he's finishing up, that brings out a good point. If there are certain things that you want us to try, we've got a list of stuff that
you know,
we're going to aim
someone,
for.
Someone
but
actually,
heck, if someone says, hey, I want to see you guys build this, we'll give it a try.
You know,
but we have to know.
Someone asked for us to do a horror theme for next month, and they asked us to do like a book of tomes and such and books.
Books!
I think that's going to be a lot of fun trying something.
Done. We're doing books. We'll do like a little library worth of books or some such.
It's going to be
at least a row of them.
Oh, I found more moss.
More moss! Because... maybe I shouldn't point you in directions, Mr. Overkill on things.
No,
it's looking great.
You told me moss.
I did tell you moss.
Why are you so mean
to
me?
Great. And
I
like
love
I was just
you.
Saying, like I was just saying, we keep talking about this as a scepter, but you know, I was joking about it being a table centerpiece. The more I think about it, the more I think that this whole thing could be like a whole centerpiece of, you know, the evil villain. So you could wear it. It could also be prop in and of itself.
See how look they neat. They look
they,
so
they
neat.
They do. They do. They look kind of cool.
I love them.
And so this shape.
Oh, switch.
Switch. Woo. All right. So one thing is that I love this piece on the front of the clip here.
Yes.
But it's real shiny.
It is very shiny.
I'm going to fix that.
Oh, I hate this thing. Wait, I know what to do. Yep, go for it.
Oh, yeah.
I have asthma. This is what happens. Oh, that smells nasty. Yep,
You smell nasty.
Girl. So, the tool he's using is called a Dremel. And that thing is pretty neat. It's like a little piece of sandpaper on the edge. And it is... sanding down that piece. It's actually
it's
not as shiny
it's
now.
It's not
I like
crazy
this.
Shiny. I still
Ooh,
left
that's
it
warm. Wow.
I still left it kind of shiny, so that it looks kind of like an edge. It's got a little bit of sheen to it, but not crazy mirror like it was. So that it looks a little more reminiscent of the other pieces. That none of the others look totally brand new or anything like that.
Switch.
Wait.
No!
What?
No!
That's all
you're good!
We're
not paying
right
attention,
at the,
folks.
At the
this is our
things.
Show. Combat Creations.
What you got there?
Don't worry about it. I got things.
All right.
You got things. I got things.
So,
I just
gauntlets. I think, man, we want to keep going and we want to keep adding, but I think there's also a point that I want to say, I don't know that I have another thing to add to enhance it anymore.
I'll just have to put a little lich on it.
Oh, God, dude.
All right, fine.
Oh, man.
Maybe some keys?
Stop. Look.
How about following our road?
Okay, that may work. Here, come over and find a good spot for that. Because we've
I drive him crazy, everyone. That's great.
Because we've got some foliage on the crown, we've got the black roses on the scepter piece, that actually works and ties in. The little figure and stuff is fun for a completely different project, so we want to keep it, and we want to know that we have it, but once we put it onto this, then it's a little overkill. Sometimes you got to know when it's in time to just stop and say, that's the thing.
It honestly, folks, is very hard for me to stop. He has to tell me. I'm
that's
like,
right.
No, we can do this. No, like, he probably might have dragged me away from...
All right, fix that. Glue the object, not the glue gun.
Ah, I'm gluing my finger to it.
Yes, glue your finger to it. put a little bit of yourself in that project. All right, so here we are in the time that we've been given. We now have gauntlets to add to our thing, and we've got a little more of an overall character concept. Can we go ahead and
get a, let's get a close-up on these so you guys can kind of see what we've done.
And they are a little bit different, but they are a little bit similar. So we will put straps on them and paint the white parts of the foam black or dark brown between shows, and we'll show you next week what the final product is and if the little spikes lasted when we put straps on. We'll find that out.
We will definitely find that out.
In the meantime, we're just about out of time. We're almost there.
What are we going to be creating next week is what I want.
Next week, we were working on a mantelpiece to go along with this whole thing.
All right.
Something over the
shoulder.
So they
got a crown.
A little bigger.
They got a scepter. They got bracer thingies.
And
now
that will be wrapping up February. And then we'll switch into horror for next month. Definitely some more guests. When we can have Kristen on, we will. We missed you here, Kristen.
We do hope you get better and everything.
Yes.
But guys, don't forget to always check us out every Thursday night after Ladies of Fandom at 9:30 to 10 o'clock. We got some really interesting things. If you have any questions or comments, please just message us at fanboytv.com or facebook.com.
Stick around after this for Zombie Life TV, part of our Fanboy TV block party Thursdays.
It's great. You know, I just got to say, Gavin, happy birthday, and thank you so much for letting us have our show. And we hope you, the fandom, enjoy it.
And
so,
like what we say, continue crafting.
We're Combat Creations, everyone. Have a good night.
We're building these today.
Oh, we're going there.
It's because I'm on the Mac. I'm playing off the hard drive, so it sucks.
Are you good?
Yeah, that has to do with me playing off the
hard. Are you good?
Yeah.
Bueller?
Dad?
Bueller?
Dad! Are we still on TV?
I need to know.